Hi, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we are opening up Yu-Gi-Oh's latest release, the Mega Tins, the Tins of the Pharaoh's Gods. Beautiful new tins to complete the trilogy of the fantastic tins we've had previously. So make sure to check out this video, keep an eye out for any other fantastic things that we could be getting. Lightning Storms, Alubas, Red Eyes Dark Dragoons, there's so much fantastic stuff in this set, so keep an eye out. And make sure to like this video and comment down below what your favourite card in this set is. There's so many to choose from, and if you're picking up any, good luck with your pulls as well. Alright, and we are here with our beautiful IP Mascarena playmat, but also our tin of the Pharaoh's Gods. Beautiful tin, lovely tin, very similar to the past two tins, the Millennium and the Ancient Battles tin. Very nice tins. They stack on top of each other as well, which is also very lovely for those of you who are collectors out there. But these are the new tins. So we've got, and you can have a look there, we've got Ra, we've got Obelisk, and we've got Slifer, the Sky Dragon there. Very nice little tin, much like the rest. And of course, they are filled with three mega packs, and these packs are literally mega packs. In the past, we've had some fantastic tins, and the mega tins have always been really good. This one seems to be so good, and I don't know whether that's just because we're in the moment and we think, yeah, it's great for what it's got in it, but this mega tin has got some absolutely fantastic stuff in here. So we'll go quickly through what is in each of these tins. In each of these packs, we get 18 cards, massive packs. There is a prismatic secret rare in every pack. Two ultras, two supers, one rare, and 12 commons. Very nice. It includes cards from Blazing Vortex, Lightning Overdrive, Dawn of Majesty, and Burst of Destiny, plus additional cards from the past and a few brand new cards as well. So the brand new cards, we know there's some new Egyptian God support. So if you're looking to play casually, maybe even with the decks that came out, the Obelisk and the Slifer one, those might be a decent shout. There's also new artworks for Blue Eyes White Dragon, Red Eyes Black Dragon, and a Dark Magician Girl as well. So we're very excited to open up this new tin. They're very lovely. They're very nice, very chunky. And if you're playing very casually, or if you've got a child, you take out the insert of this tin. It's a decent way to store a few cards in. So let's open up this tin and see what you get when you pop it open. And much like last few years, you've got this insert, and you've got your three mega packs within, the gorgeous mega packs, the chunky mega packs. They're all very nice and golden. Otherwise, yeah, it is just a plastic insert. You don't need that. Don't worry about that. Take it out and you can pop some cards in it. It's very nice. So let's take a look. And today we're not just going to be opening one. We have got packs from five megatins here. So we opened up five megatins for a total of 15 packs here to see what you could potentially pull in these lovely tins. Now, they come out on Thursday, so keep an eye out for then. If you're local to Folkestone, or if you have an OTS store near you, they might be able to sell it on the Wednesday, which we will be able to. So keep an eye out for that. But yeah, beautiful, beautiful packs. And there's a ton of fantastic stuff in them. If you don't buy a lot of booster packs throughout the year, these are definitely one to pick up, because they have a ton of stuff from sets from last year that have a load of fantastic and meta-relevant stuff, and a load of casual-friendly stuff as well. We talked about the God cards and stuff. So let's start opening up these packs and seeing what we get inside these gorgeous 2022 Tin of Pharaoh's Gods. All right, so begin with Gunken Suship Ikora. Very nice Gunken Suship there, an archetype that made its debut, I think, last year. Very lovely artwork going on there. We have one Kuriwei. We have the Fabled, a bank Fabled cards getting a little bit of love in here. EMR. Zexal Entrust, which is very nice, very nice. Materiactor, Gigo Boros. I remember Materiactors coming out. Very nice. We have Masquerade, the Blazing Dragon, as our first super rare, working with the Despia archetype that has been on fire recently. We have Book of Lunar Eclipse. That is a interesting reprint there. We have Flu Wanderees and Toucan, or Token. Token, it is a Toucan though. Very nice ultra rare there. Flu Wanderees, obviously. Fantastic archetype as well. And doesn't need a lot of extra deck, which is very good too.
So we wonder, is there? We have Dragonlock Pyron. Very cool worm monster. Beautiful, beautiful card. And we have our branded opening. Lovely, lovely secret rare there. Beautiful one. Again, with that Despia archetype, that branded archetype that really was absolutely fire this past year. Working with that Fallen of Abaz structure deck as well. Beautiful, beautiful pull in that branded opening. Fantastic one to see. We have Ruddy Rose Witch. We obviously got a load of Rose support. Ruddy Rose Dragon is in this set as well. So do keep an eye out for that one. But Ruddy Rose Witch, a nice rare. And I do like a rare as well. Rare is cool. We have Magic Key Unlocking there. Pazuzzle or Pazuzzle. I do like these one-offs, these very nice names. We have Night Sword Serpent. Zoroa the Magistus Conflagrant Calamity. Lovely Magistus card there. Flying Red Carp. Some more fish, if you remember Duels from the Deep. And Bee Trooper Light Flapper. There's a lot of Bee Trooper support in this set as well. So if you like your Bee Troopers, this one is definitely one to check out. But that was our first pack. Very nice. Very nice indeed. All right, next one. Let's see what we can get. So we got Zexal Alliance there. We have Dragoonity Knight Gormfeo Bar. Definitely said that wrong, but Dragoonity stuff is cool. Gizmek Tanninguku, the Immobile Intellect. We have Icy Breeze Refrain for the Wind Witch. There's a lot of Wind Witch stuff reprinted in this set as well, which was very needed. Chronomaly Magella Globe. We have Sacred Tree Beast Hyperiton. We have Virtual World Gate as our first super rare. And Gauki or Gooki finishing move. Nice Gooki there. Mimicking Maneater Bug. Remember this? This retrain. Love the Maneater Bug. The Mimicking Maneater Bug. All these retrains are very nice and nostalgic for players. And we have one of the new cards, the Breaking Ruin God. This is the obelisk specific new card. So let's go a little bit into it, I think, and see what it does. So the activation of this card or its effects can't be negated, nor can its effects be negated. Special summon an obelisk from your hand or GY, and if you do, it's unaffected by your opponent's card effects this turn. If you tribute two or more monsters you control at the same time to activate your card or effect while you control Obelisk the Tormentor, like doing his effect, you can banish this card from your GY, banish all monsters in your opponent's GY, and if you do, inflict 500 damage to your opponent for each. Nice effect. Very good for casual play. I really like it around the dinner table or the kitchen table. They're just really fun things to play and to ruin the world like Obelisk would. We have one of the standouts as I was looking at this set. We have the beautiful, incredible Ecclesia the Virtuous. A fantastic card that has definitely been one that people have been after in the Albaz and in the Sword Soul kind of decks. Lovely, beautiful card. Fantastic to get a reprint. It's a stunning card. It's absolutely beautiful with a fantastic effect. And if you do, make sure to check this one out because it has got some absolutely wonderful stuff going on with it. Incredible. Incredible. We have Judge of the Ice Barrier, some Ice Barrier stuff. We had that Ice Barrier structure deck actually. It's probably like a few years ago now, but that was still cool. And so working with those, it's very nice. Still a decently loved archetype, I want to say. Undaunted Bumpkin Beast, Destiny Hero Denier, Gunken Su Ship Uni, Supernatural Danger Zone, Live Twin Sunny Snitch, and Bee Trooper Landing. All right, next one. Some fantastic pulls already, and we've only two packs in. So we have Arm Dragon Thunder level 5, and I believe all the Arm Dragon stuff is reprinted in this set as well. So if you want a bit of that retrain, there you go. Metal Foes Vanisher there. Psychic Eraser Laser, great name. Another Arm Dragon. Gizmek Inaba. We have Book of Lunar Eclipse again. We have ZS Armed Sage. We have Machina Unclass Bear. Interesting Machina support there. We also have some more interesting support in DD Assault Carrier. Very nice. And we have Ghost Ogre and Snow Rabbit, a card that has been reprinted so much, but is still pretty nice. Especially in this prismatic secret rare. It's absolutely stunning, as you can see there. Fantastic hand trap, lovely effect. Not the best hand trap, but it's still pretty good, definitely say. We have Glacier Aquamador, another retrain. Majestic Absorption, working with Stardust Dragon or any Synchro Monster, which is quite nice. Shinobi Insect. We have B-Trooper Sting Lancer. Ice Jade's getting a little bit of love in this set too. B-Trooper Formation and Live Twin Sunny Snitch again. So that is what you would get in one tin. So three Prismatic Secret Rares. It's still pretty good. Like, all the Prismatics we've gotten so far are pretty nice. Pretty nice indeed. We have Dragoonity Knight again. Masters Diploman, Zexal Entrust, Tri-Brigade Rendezvous, Guitar Gurnard's Duo Nigus, interesting, Arm Dragon Blitz, Sunvine Crossbreed, so you get some of that Sunvine, Sun Avalon, Paleozoic Cambro Raster, very nice. We have Heavenly Zephyr Miradora, lovely one to see, Rebuildeer, as Yu-Gi-Oh players know, we love a pun. And we have our Ruddy Rose Dragon in that beautiful prismatic secret rare as well. It is absolutely stunning. The camera does not... It does it a little bit of justice, but it is still very nice to see on the eyes. A lovely, lovely synchro monster. And a nice retrain in the Black Rose. Very good one there. Right, we have Windwitch Diamond Bell. Lovely reprint. Magicky Beast, Magicky Dragon. Gunken Sioux Ships. And another one, and then Undaunted Bumpkin Beast and a Shinobi again. So we're getting a lot of the commons again. We're seeing some of that Sioux Ship, that Bee Trooper, and some other archetypes as well. Some of the archetypes getting a little bit of extra love. We have you and AI for those Cybers monsters. Basil Rose Shot for those Rose Dragons. Judgment of the Branded. Black Eyes, the Plunder Patrol Sea Guide. Love a Plunder Patrol card. Materia Actor, Gunken Sioux Ship Shari, and all of that flavor text is absolutely beautiful. Loving a card with a ton of flavor text. We have White Knight of Dogmatica for the Dogmatica archetype. Pharaonic Guardian Sphinx. Very interesting card, working with the Tins, of course, and the Pharaoh's Gods. We have Heritage of the Light as well here. Tri-Brigade Kit. So Tri-Brigade's also getting a little bit of love in this past year, working with a load of different archetypes. Tri-Brigade's really cool, working with Beast Warriors and all Winged Beast archetype, and it's lovely to see in this secret rare. Foiling. Thrawn the Discipled Angel. Magicky Mech Musket. Love the Magickies. Ice Jade. Dino Wrestlers. More Ice Jades. B-Troopers. And Meowsclick. Meowsclick. Okay, Tri-Brigade Rendezvous. We have Parametal Foes Azortless. We have Windwitch Freeze Bell. And these Windwitches in common is very nice too. We have some Buijin support. Sun Avalon Daphne. It's a super. Beast King Unleashed. We have Gaia Armor Dragon Shell. Very beautiful synchro monster there in Ultra. The True Sun God is another new one. This one working with the Winged Dragon of Ra. So when this card is activated, add a Winged Dragon of Ra or one card that mentions it from your deck to your hand. Except this card. Monsters except the Winged Dragon of Ra can't attack the turn they are special summoned. Very nice effect. Once per turn during your main phase, you can send this card from the field or one Winged Dragon of Ra Immortal Phoenix from your deck to the GY. Then send one Winged Dragon of Ra from your monster zone to the GY. Interesting effect, continuous one as well, working with Winged Dragon. And we have the wonderful Albion, the Branded Dragon as well, working with your Fallen of Albaz archetype, making it pop. If you picked up those structure decks, this is a fantastic tin to pick up because it's got so much support in there as well. And Virtual World, Otohime. Nice one. So we've got Ice Jade, we've got Cynet, Crosswipe, Gunken Sioux Ship, Ultra Bee Trooper, Absolute Hercules. Magicky Duo, B-Trooper, Flying Sting. Tons of B-Trooper support. Again, if you're playing casually and love a B-Trooper, this Megatin is full of them. Alright, Dragoonity Knight. We got Plunder Patrol again. Most of these commons we've seen before. Converging Wills Dragon, actually. I don't think we have. Working with Majestic and Stardust. Danamari at Ignista. Some Ignista support here. Googie finishing move again. Tri-Brigade Bear Brum, the Rampant Rampager. Nice link one there for the Tri-Brigade archetype. Sprite Blessing for your ritual monsters. We have Small World. Nice. Love Small World. Cute little card. Cute spell. And we have Sacred Scrolls of the Gizmec Legend. And then other cards we have seen before. Cool. All right. Branded in White, I don't think. Stay Sailor Ramarin as well, I don't think is one that we've seen before. So that's kind of cool. Another Attic Nista. Binary Blader there. It's quite a nice Cyberverse monster. Nibiru in Ultra. Very nice. Love a Nibiru. And I think Nibiru got printed in the last Megaton, I think. Or something like that. So that's quite nice. Sprite's Blessing once again. And we have Armed Dragon Thunder level 7 in that Prismatic Secret Rare. Very lovely. Very nice. And B-Trooper Scout Buggy as our rare. So a load of B-Troopers and that one too. Alright, so I think what we'd like to see now is any of those new artworks for any of the Blue Eyes, the Red Eyes and the Dark Magician Girl would be lovely. I'd love a Lightning Storm as well. Lightning Storm is cool. Red Eyes Dark Dragoon, obviously fantastic as well. Got High Rich Wart, the Revive Sky God, which is the Slifer, specific Egyptian God card, the new one from the set, which is very nice. Working with Monster Reborn as well, which is quite cool. We have Branded Bond as our second Ultra, and Dual Tower, which I believe is also another new card. At the start of each battle phase, each player can reveal one monster from their deck that does not have a question mark attack. You can banish them face down. Then, the player who revealed the monster with the highest attack, you can special summon one monster from their hand, and it can attack directly while on the field. Once per turn during the end phase, you can activate this effect. If you control this card during the end phase of your next turn, destroy all cards on the field. Really interesting card there. Lovely field spell, and if you've seen the anime, you'll know where this is from, and it's very cool. And we have Fluwanderese and Snarl. Snarl. We have Aeropix 3 there. Some interesting common cards as well, common reprints too. Alright, so yeah, but these are packed, absolutely packed with some fantastic stuff. Some casual stuff as well that could definitely be cool. Trap Tricks Vesiculo. Very nice Trap Trick card there. We have another Gooky finishing move. Synchro Overtake for your Synchro monsters. And we have Orvain, the Essence of Vanity. Yeah. Really interesting. Very nice, easy to go into level 2 fusion monster. And it's a tuna. Which is very cool. And we have a ZS Ascended Sage. Alright. Next one. I think that first tin might have peaked with it. I think. Starmine there. Interesting reprint. Fluwanderese and Stree. Getting our more of that Fluwanderese. Radiant Vorescence. We have Contract with the Abyss. Very nice card. Dark Eye Nightmare, really interesting reprint there. And another Incredible Ecclesia, the Virtuous. Very nice to get two from one opening. And Majestic Mirage. Yeah, two from one opening is very good. I was hoping for some of the new stuff, but I'll take two Ecclesias, definitely, at this point. All right. Fluwanderese and Empen, getting a load of those different Fluwanderese. Warrock Skylar. Warrock was a fantastically interesting TCG exclusive archetype. I love the art style, and some of the effects are really interesting as well. Hopefully we get more support for them in the future. And Contract with the Abyss again. And Pot of Prosperity, a fantastic one that I have not talked about yet, but a lovely input in this set. Banish 3 or 6 cards of your choice from the extra deck face down. For the rest of this turn, after this card resolves, any damage your opponent takes is halved, but you excavate cards from the top of your deck equal to the number of cards you banished. Add one of those to your hand and put the rest on the bottom of your deck in any order. So it's pretty nice to get specific things that you're after. Love a Pot of Prosperity. And we have Armed Dragon level 10 white as well, which is a lovely rare to pull. Very nice rare. Alright, we're one Megatin left. 3 packs. That Pot of Prosperity is very nice though. Very good. Blizzard Bell there. For your Win Wish. We have Ghost Reaper and Winter Cherries. Came out a few years ago and one that was pretty popular. Now available in Super Rare. Atignista again. We have AI Meechu. We have Scrap Raptor. Really interesting Ultra Rare there. And we have another Albion, the Branded Dragon, as our Prismatic Secret. Okay. Some more Bee Troopers, Magnificent and Magic-y stuff. Okay, so we have Machina Rune Force again. Live Twin Lila Treat. There is some Live Twin reprints in this as well. So if you're looking for those and weren't able to pick up the set they were in, this is a decent shout. Dark Ruler No More. Fantastic card. Beautiful to see in Ultra Rare. I love this card. And it was reprinted pretty recently, I want to say, in a structure deck as well. A reprint never hurts. And we have the Revived Sky God again. And another Pot of Prosperity. Very nice. Lovely pull. And some more Bee Troopers. Oh, some Rocket Support as well in here. And our final pack here. Hopefully we can get something we haven't seen yet. Be lovely to get one of those alternate arts. But, you know, honestly, all of the secret rares are pretty nice. All right, so Ghost Mourner and Moonlit Chill. Another one of those hand traps for the ghost girls. Trap Tricks, Cularia. We have Dark Infant Adignista. We have Dogmatica Genesis. And we have Ghost Ogre and Snow Rabbit in Prismatic Secret Rare. It's a very beautiful card nonetheless. We already have one, unfortunately, but that is okay. Rank up Magic, Zexal Force, some Morphly Wanderees there, and Suship. So, some beautiful stuff you get in. Loads of rares, actually. Rares are nice. Rares are kind of cool. Super rares. Very good too. Ultra rares, of course, very nice. You have the new Egyptian god support in that as ultra rare. You got things like Dark Ruler No More, which is very good. And Nibiru, of course, in ultra rare as well, is very nice. Yeah, some lovely ultra rare things as well. And of course, our secret rare prismatics. We got a couple of ghost ogres. We got a couple of Ecclesias and a couple of Pot of Prosperities, and a couple of Albions as well. So we got a decent amount of fantastic stuff in here. There is a load of other stuff. We got Ron Ruddy Rose Dragon as well. But there are some other beautiful things you can pull in this set too. Not only just those alternate arts, but things like Lightning Storm, Red Eyes Dark Dragoon. The list goes on, honestly. So if you can find a list of everything in this set, there's tons of it. We didn't get to pull some of the fantastic stuff, but we still got to get some of the stuff that some of you might be interested in picking up. Some Tri-Brigade support in there, branded stuff as well. If you're looking to pick up any of the set, head on over to the website and pre-order it. We've got a load available still on the website. If you're local to Folkestone, pop on down on Wednesday and we should have them available then. But if you are picking up any, good luck with your pulls. Hopefully you get some of the stuff that you're after. Do make sure to like this video. Comment down below what your favorite card in this set is, what you're looking to pull as well. We love to see that and love to know what the community is looking out for. Thanks for watching. I've been Johnny for Chaos Cards, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Please do make sure to like this video, comment down below, and share it with as many people as you can. And if you are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe for more opening videos in the future. I'll see you next time.